think I put them in the right order? Do you need to test it?
Good evening, friends. This is our third of our Vesper series and our second of our Holden evening prayer services. Vespers comes from the Greek word that means evening, and even before the fourth century, there were evidence that the early Christians gathered at sunset to pray. The monastics, particularly the Benedictines, maintained this practice throughout the centuries, a time of stopping, resting, and reflecting in our relationship and our life with God. So tonight, as we gather, I invite you to watch the screens, follow along as we sing our prayers this evening. Smith and his ensemble will lead us in our song. Smith will guide you by motioning with your hand when it's time for you to sing, or when on the screen it says all, that's all of us. And the rest of it, just let it wash over you. Let the music fill your spirit and be guided in this evening service. Let us begin.
You are the light of the world.
May our prayers come before you, O God, as incense, and may your Spirit surround and fill us, so that in unison with all creation we might sing your praise and your love in our lives.
Amen.
Tonight, our scripture is from Luke chapter 1. Verses 57 through 66. This is the birth of John the Baptist. Listen to God's word. When it was time for Elizabeth to have her baby, she gave birth to a son. Her neighbors and relatives heard that the Lord had shown her great mercy, and they shared her joy. On the eighth day, they came to circumcise the child, and they were going to name him after his father Zechariah. But his mother spoke up and said, "No, he is to be called John." They said to her, "There is no one among your relatives who has that name." Then they made signs to his father to find out what he would like to name the child. He asked for a writing tablet, and to everyone's astonishment, he wrote, "His name is John." Immediately his mouth was opened and his tongue set free, and he began to speak, praising God. All the neighbors were filled with awe, and throughout the hill country of Judah, people were talking about all these things. Everyone heard this wondered about it, asking, "What then is this child going to be?" For the Lord's hand was with him. This is the word of our Lord. Thanks be to God. We'll take a moment of silence to reflect on our text tonight. Light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it.
Thank you.
Great and merciful God, source and ground of all goodness and life, give to your people the peace that surpasses all understanding and the will to live your gospel of mercy and justice through Jesus Christ our Lord. God, remember us in your love and teach us to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Let us bless our God.
Praise and thanks to God.
Thank you all for joining us at our Vesper series, and special thanks to Smith, Ed, Flory, Karen, and Sharon, and Burl for leading us tonight and yet last week. I invite you to share the signs of peace with each other as we exit back out into the world. Amen.